Hey, it's Kathy from IMG, here to talk to you today about suppression lists. So the only thing more important than who receives email communication is who doesn't receive email communication. So you can utilize suppression lists to remove people from automated engagement programs, list emails, and really any email communication that you want to send through account engagement, formerly known as Pardot. So I'll walk through a few use cases today. There's really two types of lists that we could break these categories into. There's static lists and there's dynamic lists. So dynamic lists in account engagement or Pardot are constantly updating based on the criteria that we select. So let's say I want to run a new campaign, email campaign to drum up some business from the leads that we have, but I don't want to market to any contacts because I want to avoid marketing to those that I already work with. We could set up a suppression list like this. Their CRM status is a lead and run those rules. Now this will give me an auto updating list of all leads that I have in my CRM. You also have the option to do CRM prospect type is not contact. But in the case of suppression, I like to group individuals together rather than remove them. It just makes it easier when it comes to actually suppressing them on my lists. The other example of a suppression list is the static list. So these are typically thought of in two ways. It's a group that you're going to import. So you could have a CSV file of event attendees or a list of, in my case, current clients that I work with, pulled from an external report. So I imported that report and now I have 61 prospects here that I do not want to market to in some instances because I know that they're ongoing clients in some cases. And then I always tend to create kind of one-off suppression lists that I manually add individuals to. So let's pull up a prospect record. We'll use my record for the test. With lists, you have the ability to add individuals to static lists. You do not have the ability to add them to dynamic lists because they must meet criteria for dynamic lists. So for a static list, if someone responds to one of my automated campaigns and I start a conversation with them, I may not want them to continue on an automated sequence. That's where suppression comes into play. So I have this list of people who engaged with me that I want to remove from campaigns going forward. So if I want to make sure a prospect record, in this case me, doesn't receive automation, I could add in my suppression list. Engaged with Cassie, nurture suppression. So now as long as I use that suppression list going forward, Cassie will not receive these emails. So there are a few different ways that you can create lists. Now the question is, how do you utilize them? So let's look at this example in the case of an engagement program. Let's say I'm running a webinar or again, really any campaign, and I do not want to invite any of my current clients or anyone that I'm actively speaking to. You'll see everything that you send in account engagement has two categories. There's recipients and there's suppression. Here I can very easily drop in my suppression list for the one that I manually add people to, or maybe even my dynamic suppression list. So now whether I'm adding people individually to the suppression list or if they fall into the suppression list based off the criteria that I've identified in my dynamic list, they will no longer receive marketing communication for this specific cadence. And then the other area where you may utilize these are within list emails. So more of the one-off emails that you send. So let's look at a draft here. This would be monitored under the sending tab. Same concept. You have the list for your recipients that you want to send to and suppression that you do not want to send to. The thought process is the same. grouping those individuals together who need to be quickly removed from communication. If they are on your recipient list and also on your suppression list, they will not receive the email as long as they are on that suppression list. If you have any other questions about email suppression or anything involving account engagement, please feel free to reach out. Thank you.